Okay, so it says draw the condensed structural formulas and give the IUPAC names, it's the systematic names, for the products from the hydrolysis of N-methylpentanamide with HCl. Okay. Oh, I didn't go over amide names? Oh, yeah, it's the same. You just put A-M-I-D-E.
Even the common names, it's the same.
Yeah, we don't usually do that many common names, but yes, this would be the same. Sorry. So let's break this down as we go along. I thought we did naming before, but so there's N-methylpentanamide. So it's five carbons, right? So I'm going to draw the reactant. So I got to put four in my chain, and then I have to do the amide part. And it's going to have an N. I'm going to draw it out. N-methyl, right? So I put a methyl group on the nitrogen. What's missing in that formula? A hydrogen, all right. And then you guys know, because we talked about it a little bit now, or know in the sense that it should be there. There's a lone pair there. We don't have to have it there. I just thought I'd draw it in there. So that's the reactant. Now what we can do is we can draw the product for the acid hydrolysis. So what you need is you need, for this left part, this is the hydrolysis product. This will be the carboxylic acid. What's that? Where's the H come from?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So in the reaction, actually, if you're drawing the whole reaction out the way the book likes to do it, they put H2O, and then you put an HCl in here. And then there's an arrow to the products, and the product is going to be the carboxylic acid. And the ammonium salt, okay? So carboxylic acid is going to look like, let's see if I have room on the next slide, actually. Double check. Yeah. So I'm going to copy this part real quick. Hang on. And then I'll go to the next slide where I've actually left myself a little more room. Okay, so I left myself a little bit more room here. So the carboxylic acid is going to have five carbons in it, right? That's the left-hand side. So I should have, again, CH3, CH2, 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 and then C double bond O, OH. Now, the amine that would come off comes from that. Okay, it's under acidic conditions, so you're going to get an ammonium ion. So it's going to pick up actually two hydrogens here and have a positive charge. So you'll end up with N and then CH3. And then I'll have that H that I started with, and then I'll end up adding two hydrogens like this. And then what's the only thing that I'm missing now? Cl minus. Now, there's all kinds of ways that this part on the right can be drawn, so you have to be a little bit careful. It might be, and most likely be written as CH3NH3 plus Cl minus. In other words, they'd write it in this order. They would write it like that, most likely. Okay. Go ahead.
I'm sorry, I'm still confused. Where originally did H comes out.
Which H?
What does that mean?
This one?
Yeah.
Oh, well, how many bonds does nitrogen have to have?
Oh.
Has to have three bonds and a lone pair. So
okay,
I only,
I get it. Yeah.
When we say it's N-methyl, N-methyl and then the name, you have to assume that one end is attached to the C double bond O, and then there's one missing, so it's a hydrogen.
Yeah.
No, it's just next to it. It's the opposite charge, so they like hang out together, kind of thing. It's an ionic bond, but it's kind of hard to show ionic bonds like that. It's actually, most people would get it if you did this, like, oh, there's a plus next to the minus. They don't think about the bond that's in between there. But yeah, it's just the way it's drawn. A lot of times when you did Lewis structures, I don't know if you learned this in your 3A class or not, a lot of times when people do Lewis structures of ions, they put brackets like this around them so you don't get confused about there being a bond in between. It's just charge attraction. Okay? And that's what an ionic bond is. Okay. Good-ish? No?
Do we have to
know
the names?
Yeah, so I'll do the names, but I got so much junk up there, I'm going to do it on the next slide. I'm going to try to copy it. Yeah, oh well, I'll copy it and see what happens. So I'm going to do the names. Let me do some erasing here real quick. Oops, can't write with an eraser, turns out. Okay, so that top one, right? So the names of the product, that's pent, right? It's 5. So pentane, pentanoic acid, yeah? OIC, remember all that? Pentanoic acid. Now, so this is, I know what I want to call it, but I'm trying to avoid calling it by its common name. So that's methanamine, right? So it's methanammonium ion. So methan and then ammonium, just like ammonia becomes ammonium when it's a positive charge. And it's with a chlorine, so we would say chloride. Like that. So methanammonium chloride.
So in this case, the chloride doesn't go on the front?
What's that?
The chloride doesn't go on the front?
Well, for ionic compounds, do you remember the rule for ionic? It's an ionic compound, so this goes back to general chemistry stuff. The cation is always first, anion is always second for ionic compounds. Yeah, if it was an organic compound, it was attached, you would put chloro something, but yeah.
N-chloro.
Right, because it's ionic. So you just name it as an ionic compound. So you're naming the cation first, methanammonium. And then the halogen is the anion, so we just call it chloride. All right. That's it?
At least it's multiple choice,
right? Right. You'll be able to eliminate some stuff. It will be multiple choice. I've made the determination I have no time for grading.
Chloride ion?
Huh? No, because it's part of a compound. You get rid of the ion, yeah. Because it's methanammonium ion, too, right? Methanammonium. Anyways, yeah. All right. What's that? Pentanoic acid? Yeah. Oh, that's the base hydrolysis. So let's do base hydrolysis of the same thing, right? N-methyl pentanamide. So let me just write it out. Plus NaOH. And I'll end up with the carboxylate salt. So I'm going to draw an arrow here. And I'll write CH3, a lot of CH3s and CH2s. So what's the carboxylate salt? I'll put an O, right? O, N-A. Again, that's an ionic compound. When we name it, the cation will go first, okay? When we get there. We're not there yet. And then the other thing is going to be the amine, right? So I'm going to have like this. That actually just comes from there. You just end up adding a hydrogen to it. So the amine is just methanamine, right?
Can you write it as NH2CH3?
Oh, yeah. I only draw it like that here so that you can see how the bonds are, see how they broke apart. But, yeah, you could also, in more commonly, you would see it as CH3NH2. Usually they would put the carbon first and then the nitrogen. Kind of like the natural order of things, carbon's first. So we're going to name this carboxylate salt. So that was pentanoic acid from the previous slide. So pentanoic, it becomes 8. So it's pentanoate. So in front of here, you have to write sodium. So sodium pentanoate. Okay. Again, it goes first because it's ionic. Would you ever get the plus minus? It's ionic. Whatever the cation is always goes first in the name. So this is just a different way. Like this is just a different way of writing that. Yeah, I just thought I should show you like how you probably see it in a multiple choice comes out like that. Yeah. So it's an ionic compound. Anytime it's ionic, see pluses and minuses. Cation always goes first. Anion always goes second. Oh, because we did the hydrolysis of an amide, makes an amine. Yeah. Yeah. Any questions? I'm sure there's lots of questions. We'll resolve some of them where in lab, and at the end of lecture, because I only have this section and the next section, then I'm done for the lecture. I'm not going to cover. I'm not going to try to jam more things into your head. Unless you really want me to. Usually the answer is no. Just more practice. Why don't you go ahead and try to draw the hydrolysis products for that one. And it's acid hydrolysis. And then we'll go around and see how you guys are doing. Actually, I won't start staring at you and walking by you for a minute or two. But I will come by. Peer. You can do bond lines too. Bond lines so much faster.
Is it?
Oh, there is an H missing. Ha! Nice job. I'd give you a foil sticker for that. I don't have any on me. No, I'm serious. You know what I found at my mom's house this weekend? I was going through the drawer of junk, you know? She has this collection of stuff from when I was born and, like, elementary school. And I found my name on a strip of paper with a bunch of stars next to it that my teacher cut out and then gave to my mom. So you recognize it's very important. Yeah, well, just, no extra points. I'll give you foil stickers, but no extra points.
The reason this one had water is because it was an acid.
Uh-huh.
That's why, and then this one's a base, so it doesn't have
Yeah, it doesn't need it, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Because this, you only need the O from this.
Yeah.
Here, you need the O from this, because there's no O there.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. And then just
and
name
them? This is plus and minus, and just name them, yeah. Anybody want me to peek at theirs and see if they got it right? I can go get my foil stickers. Oh, yeah, good. So far, so good. And then you're just missing what that becomes. So it'll be the ammonium ion because it's acid, okay? You guys are getting it. Yeah, with a plus here. Yeah. Yeah.
What?
Is she talking trash to you?
I don't know. I can't.
Chemistry trash? Got your Emmys. Okay. So I see a lot of people got the acid part right. So I get, if I do bond line, people will hate me, so I'm not going to. I'll just write the way most people do. But bond line is my friend. So that part becomes the acid, like that. And then you're going to take this part and make an ammonium salt out of it. So it'll be CH3. And then N, and then it's H3. It actually picks up two hydrogens. That has a plus, and then it has the Cl minus. That's normally how you see it drawn, maybe without the bond even in the middle, as a condensed structure. So again, this is named as an acid, so 1, 2, 3. So what is that? Propane, right? So propanoic. Acid, yeah, bless you. And the other one is, again, that methane ammonium chloride. If you can read that, you're better than my teachers were in elementary school. Yeah, they take an amphetamine and they methylate. They put a CH3 on it. That's meth. It's unreasonably easy to do too. It turns out. No. Well, no. But it's probably a common name. Yeah, amphetamine is a neurotransmitter derivative. Of adrenaline. Yeah.
So what's the name of that? The final? Is it the methanammonium?
Methanammonium chloride is just the name of that.
So it's the whole thing.
And propanoic acid is the name of that.
Yeah.
No, it's two separate names, yeah. Because there's two different products in the end. Oh, huh. Was that the last section, really? That
I skipped something. Huh? Look at that. I did skip the name.
Hang on, let's go through this real quick. Those are amides. No? Oh, okay, so let's talk about this really quick, because you do need to know this, too. So, I'm going to do it on the board again, so I'm going to pause this recording, because you can't see it on the board.